So in this video, I'm going to be showing you some successful Cattleya propagations. I'm also going to talk about how I got them to bloom in the next bloom cycle. And then I'm going to give you an update to show you exactly how they are doing now and also how I am growing them in many different methods. So as you guys know, one of the easiest methods to propagating our orchids is actually through the division process, where we take our orchids and we actually divide out the pseudobulbs. And it is recommended that you have at least 3 healthy pseudobulbs per division. Because the more pseudobulbs you have means the more energy it has to sustain itself and also to encourage new growth. And I definitely do want to point out that what I've discovered with my divisions, when I did have more pseudobulbs on the division, it actually really did show and prove that it was much stronger and much more capable of bouncing back and even growing as normal. In some cases, it didn't even skip a beat, where in the next bloom cycle, it did bloom. So yes, indeed, the more bulbs that you do have within your division, you just have a greater chance of it really growing out for you and definitely bouncing back. And this golf green hair pig right here was an actual division that I purchased from the TAM Miami Orchid Show. It was a 4 bulb division and I mounted it on this wooden piece right here. And as you can see, it did grow very, very well. It did not skip a beat at all. It continued to grow very, very healthy. And within the next bloom cycle, it did bloom for us. And as you can see right here, it's sheathing yet again. And this particular Cattleya division right here is of a purpurata cross with a digbiana. This was a 4 bulb division in which we decided to go ahead and grow it within a mounting basket. And if you guys want to see that mounting basket project, you can click on that link right here. It'll take you to that video. So about 7 months ago, we did do a division on this Cattleya right here. We simply put some wooden logs within this basket, also added some Landsias, and I do have to say I was so shocked to see how well this Cattleya grew within this mounting basket. But not only how well it grew, but to see that it did not skip a beat at all. As you can see, it is growing its huge sheath right here, and hopefully we'll be seeing a bloom from this gal. So indeed, this Cattleya right here has grown without a problem at all, and as a matter of fact, it seems as though it didn't even notice that it was propagated at all. Now, about a month ago, I did show you guys this mounting project that I did mainly with Cattleyas. Now, what I did forget to mention was the fact that majority of these Cattleyas were actually divisions. So let's go ahead and take a look at the most successful divisions now. So although this one seems pretty small, this actually had 4 growths on this actual division, so it did quite well for us. And as you're seeing right here, there is a whole lot of root action going on with this division. And as a matter of fact, you are seeing the roots have begun to attach to the wooden surface, as you are seeing. And indeed, this is growing as normal, and you can even see some new growths coming about. And this one right here was a very nice sized division. It actually had 4 pseudobulbs, and if we take a look, there are a whole lot of new growths in the roots, and they are beginning to attach themselves on the wooden surface as well. And also, if we take a good look right here, you are seeing a nice sized new growth. And if we take a close look, you will also notice nubbins that are beginning to form throughout this Cattleya as well. So definitely growing nicely. Now, this one in particular did have a lot of pseudobulbs, and I think it had about 7 or maybe even 8 in this division. And as you can see right here, those roots are coming about and indeed are also attaching to the surface. So definitely without skipping a beat, and hopefully we'll see this bloom within the next season. And this one right here is a nice 5 bulb division. You can definitely see those nice root tips that are growing out. But what's even more amusing than this is that not only are you seeing these beautiful little root tips coming right along, but you're also seeing some beautiful new growths as well. And this one has 1, 2, and also 3. So bravo, little division, bravo. And this particular division right here is of a golden zeal pumpkin, and this is a rather large division containing 6 bulbs, and this division was done about a month ago. And as you can see, it's growing rather well. This is the latest growth right here that has come about, so growing right along. And as you can see, the roots are really nice and plump, just growing so hardy. You're also going to notice that new growth right here, or that nubbin, future pseudobulb. And you're gonna notice that throughout, that there are little nubbins on this plant. So indeed, this is gonna take up rather nicely. I do not believe that this will skip a beat at all in its growth, and as a matter of fact, this should bloom within the next bloom cycle. And this particular one right here is yet again another bare root division. Nice size, has about 5 pseudobulbs. This is a Lotogyceae that was divided a good 3 months ago. And although we are seeing not a whole lot of root action going on, as a matter of fact, there's only one particular root right here, but I'm happy to see that, because just as long as it has a root, it has a way to replenish and nurture the plant. So indeed, happy for this one single strong root. And I'm also happy to see that there are nubbins that are growing throughout this plant. So indeed, hopefully soon, this will definitely spruce back up for us and come alive with a whole lot of growths, fingers crossed. And these 3 Cattleya divisions right here are actually growing on my pizza mounts. And I want to say that they were mounted about 2 months ago. And as you see, they're growing quite well. And this particular Cattleya right here is of a Cattleya maxima, and although the bulbs aren't that large, we still have a good 7 of them. So indeed, it has a lot of energy to go around and a lot of growths as well. And if we take a look at the root system, we are seeing that there are a lot of root action going on right here. And if we turn it around, we're also going to see some root action on the other side as well, along with the new growths. And you can see 2 new growths coming right along right there. And then again, turning it to the other side, you are seeing that one growth. So indeed, we have 3 new growths with such a nice root system. And if we take a close look at the inner part of the leaf right here, you are going to notice that there is a sheath that is growing. So indeed, this maxima right here did not skip a beat at all and is growing as normal. And this particular division right here on this pizza mount is a hippodamia, and this actually has 2 divisions right here with several bulbs. And this has grown exceedingly well on this pizza mount and also has a whole lot of new growths. And this one right here is a 2 bulb division, and I went ahead and potted up this one. This is a Christian star that was divided, I would say, about 3 months ago. And if we go ahead and take a look at that root system, you definitely are seeing some pretty nice healthy roots right there coming about. And also taking a closer look, you are beginning to see some nubbins of some future pseudobulbs there. And there are quite a few that are coming about. So definitely, we look forward to this healthy division right here. Definitely growing out and doubling up in size in no time. And I do believe that this 2 bulb division will actually bloom within the next blooming season. And this one right here is a rather huge division of a Teresa Ritchie. And I divided this plant into 2. One is potted, and this one right here in particular is mounted. And as you can see, it is growing rather well. I want to say I did the division a good 5 months ago, I want to say. And this has not skipped a beat at all, growing without any problems and also blooming as well. Another orchid that did not mind and did not even know that it was propagated. Now, of course, you guys know, with the good also comes the bad, and I want to give you the truth and the whole truth of the matter. These 2 right here have not been doing as well as I would have hoped, but if I give you the background and the backdrop of exactly what happened, you will surely understand. Now, these 2 were accidental propagations. These were not intentional at all. As a matter of fact, they accidentally broke off of their original plant, and I didn't even think that they would survive. But lo and behold, they did. And this particular one bulb division right here is a lime cooler. And if we take a look at the actual leaves, you see a whole lot of desiccation and wilting going on right here. As you can see, this actual bulb has lost a whole lot of energy. And it's actually taken us a whole 6 months to even get these nice, beautiful roots right here. Only two of them, but they indeed are growing and indeed showing signs of surviving. And although its original eye has dried and shriveled up right there, we are glad to announce that there appears to be a viable eye that is beginning to grow right there. So keeping our fingers crossed on this one bulb division. And here's yet another one bulb division right here. And as you can see again, just a whole lot of wrinkling in that leaf. And then if we take a look at the root area, oh my, no viable roots whatsoever. And to be honest with you, the only thing that gives me a little bit, a hint of hope, is this viable growth right here that is growing right along. Of course, there are no roots whatsoever yet on this, but if you guys know how cattleyas grow, usually in the new growth, as it grows along, growths of roots will also begin to grow at the base of the growth. So we are indeed hoping for a lot of roots to come out of this little guy. So if you guys ever experience something like this, don't lose hope too soon. If you want to try to save it, then do just that, because you'll be surprised at just how much will and power these little guys have to survive. Now, of course, these types of divisions right here may not bounce back or recoup as quickly as the other ones with more bulbs. So you are going to have a whole lot of patience and be willing to give that extra TLC. And there you have it, folks. That is my collection of propagated cattleyas. Now, of course, I do have some more, but you know what? We'd be here all day, and I do think you guys got the gist of it, right? And I thank you guys so much for tuning in to yet another episode of My Orchid Adventures. And of course, if you guys have some tips and some suggestions on how to propagate orchids successfully, be sure to post those comments below. And I do hope that you guys learned something new from this video. I also hope that you liked this video, and if you did, please be sure to like, share, and also subscribe. Don't forget to join me on Facebook as well at My Orchid Adventures. And as you guys already know, I do truly love and appreciate you guys all. I will see you guys later, and I'll also grow with you guys later as well. Bye-bye for now. Mwah.